Trauma Kids, welcome back. If you are ever curious about why we study God's Word, the Bible, every week, it's because the Bible is the way we can know for sure what is true about God and about ourselves. It tells us how we can be forgiven of sin and have life with God forever. Have you ever been separated from your parents? Maybe you were lost in a store or at a park? How did you feel? How were you reunited with them? Something even more scary than being separated from our parents is being separated from God forever. Sin does that. Sin separates us from God. Today, we want to learn more about why God takes sin seriously. Raise your hand if you have sin in your heart. That's right. Everyone should have a hand raised because we all have sin in our heart. Does anyone remember what sin earns us? Let's think about our big picture question. What is the fair payment for sin? Here's the answer. The fair payment for sin is death. That is bad news. As we hear today's story, pay attention to the good news. Every story from the last few weeks has helped us understand the big truth about the seriousness of sin. We learned about the judges, whom God used to rescue the Israelites from the consequences of their sin, but the judges couldn't fix the cause of sin. We learned about Samson, whose death led the Israelites to defeat the Philistines. We learned how God used Boaz, a family redeemer, to provide for Ruth. We even learned how God used Samuel to deliver a message of judgment to Eli's sons, who sinned and led Israel away from God. All of these stories help us see that God takes sin seriously. Thankfully, God provided a solution for sin. Let's learn more.
Paul, a missionary and follower of Jesus, wrote a letter to the church in Ephesus. Paul taught the believers that God takes sin seriously.
First, Paul explained that people are different before they trust in Jesus and after they trust in Jesus. Paul wrote, "Before you knew Jesus, you were dead in your sins. You used to live like the world, like those who choose to disobey God. We all lived like that, doing whatever felt right to us."
Sin has consequences. The Bible says the fair punishment for sin is death. Everyone faces physical death, but people who do not trust in Jesus face spiritual death too. They are separated from God forever. This is very sad news.
But God's plan for people is good news. Paul wrote about this good news. "But God, who is full of mercy because of his great love that he had for us, made us alive with Christ. We were spiritually dead, and then he gave us life. You were saved by grace." This means that everyone who trusts in Jesus will have spiritual life. Life with God forever.
Then Paul explained what else God has done for everyone who trusts in Jesus. God raised us up with Christ and gave us a seat with him in the heavens. This way, he can show us grace and kindness, both now and for all time.
Paul wrote, "For you are saved by grace, through faith. And this is not from yourselves. It is God's gift, not from works, so that no one can boast. We are God's masterpiece, created in Christ Jesus to do the good works God has prepared for us to do."
God takes sin seriously. People deserve to die for their sins, but God loves us and sent his son, Jesus, to defeat death by dying on the cross for our sins and rising from the dead. Everyone who trusts in Jesus has eternal life.
God takes sin seriously. People deserve to die for their sins, but God loves us and sent his son, Jesus, to defeat death by dying on the cross for our sins and raising from the dead. Everyone who trusts in Jesus has eternal life.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Mia from Alexandria, Louisiana asks,
Are some sins worse than others?
That is a fantastic question. All sins are unpleasing to our Lord. All of them. God tells us not to sin. He tells us both in the Old Testament of Scripture, and He tells us in the New Testament of Scripture not to sin. He tells us that sins are not pleasing to Him, and that sin impacts and hurts people around us, and it impacts the relationship we have with God. Now, the impact is different, but all sins are dangerous. For example, some sins, some wrong things, we may just think in our heads, and that affects us internally. And if we don't act on that bad thought, if we don't do anything connected to that thought, then that is a sin that in and of itself impacts our relationship with God. And so we ask God quickly for forgiveness for the things that we think that are wrong. Now, there are also sins, sinful things that we can say and do. And the things we say and do are both offensive to God and can also hurt the feelings or physically hurt the people around us. And the things we say and do can cause hurt feelings and it can damage relationships. And some sins have a much more lasting and damaging effect on the people around us. Now, every sin deserves a severe consequence because all sin separates us from God. God looks down and He doesn't want us to sin. God wants us to live a life that is pleasing to Him. And so we should go through our life trying to figure out, how can I do more things that are pleasing to God? How can I do things that are not hurtful to the people around me? God wants our actions to be a sweet aroma unto Him. He wants our actions to be worship to Him. Why do you think living for Jesus is better than living in sin?
Our key passage says that sin requires the payment of death. The good news is that God had a plan all along to rescue people from sin through His Son, Jesus. Through Jesus' death and resurrection, we can have forgiveness and eternal life.
For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. In Christ Jesus our Lord. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. In Christ Jesus. Jesus our Lord. Romans 6:23. Eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. For the wages of sin is death,
right, Renata kids, let's pray together. Lord God, you take sin seriously. Help us to take sin seriously too. Change our hearts to desire your ways rather than our own. You are good and you love us. Amen.